One of our viewers said he's making $27,000 per year on dividends in retirement. Is this possible? We're going to explore the possibility here, so stay tuned. Thank you for watching. This is Richard with Wisdom Investor. One of the viewers that had watched one of our videos left some remarks. He had watched this video here. It says, I'm 36 years old with 300K. How much income will I have in retirement? And he left these comments here. How about buying a blue chip dividend funds? You can find 3 to 4%, which would give you about $9,800 a year on $275,000. And then he goes on to say down here at the bottom, he says, I retired 8 years ago at 62. He had $500,000. He receives $27,000 in dividend yearly and now has $530,000 during this bull market. It works. Trust me. Look into it. So this viewer here has had some good results here with some dividend funds. So we're going to investigate this. How can you make 3 to 4%? Where are you going to be able to make 3 to 4%? And just how does it work? In addition to that, we're going to look at the possibility, could you make more than 3 to 4%? Now, when we talk about dividend investing, typically there's a couple of ways of doing that. One would be to go out and buy 10, 20, 30 different stocks that pay a nice dividend. You could reinvest those dividends over years and your account will continue to grow, just like this person that was leaving the remarks. Typically, if you're going to buy your own stocks, it takes a lot more effort. I'm not saying it's a bad thing to do. There's many people that do it. They enjoy investing in multiple stocks. The other way to dividend invest is to use a dividend fund, which our viewer here was talking about. So we're going to investigate here today the dividend funds and where can you get anywhere between, say, 3 to 5 to 6% dividends from a dividend fund. Now, one of the advantages is buying your own stocks. You can monitor those. If one or two stocks are not going in the right direction, then you can surgically remove those stocks and then add some better stocks. One of the advantages to dividend fund is if you don't want to spend that much time monitoring the situation with stocks, whether it's time to buy or sell, then you can use a dividend fund. A dividend fund is much like a mutual fund. It's going to be diversified. They're going to invest in multiple companies in multiple areas of the market. And they're going to do all the investing for you. All you need to do is pick out the right fund. The first fund that we're going to look at here is Vanguard High Dividend Yield Index. Keep in mind, we're going to look at funds that range anywhere between 3 to 6% here, so we're going to start with this one first. If we go to Yahoo Finance here, we can see the current yield on this is 3.62%. Now, when looking at dividend funds, it's also important to know what the makeup is of funds. So you can go to the holdings here, and then you can look at some of the sector weightings here to just see how this fund invests its money. It's showing right now financial services 18.22%. consumer defense, healthcare, and then down here to technology. If we have a rising rate environment, financial services could definitely be good. Healthcare is a good, strong area also, but each one of these funds is going to have a different makeup. We're looking at a chart here for VYM. When do you buy the dividend funds? Now, right now, we're at the highs of the market. Typically, it's better to buy low and sell high if you're going to do that. Right now, in the environment that we're at right now, dollar cost averaging, where you would be buying a little bit each month or every 2 weeks, because we don't really know where the market's going to be. So you may buy a few high, then your market may swing to the downside. You may buy some at a lower cost. Generally speaking, looking at the big picture, this line here, this dark line here, is the 250-day moving average. I like to call things bullish to the upside, above that, and then below that would be bearish. If you're in retirement or close to retirement, you've got to be real careful that right before you need the money, you don't want the market to drop like it did back in March. Now, we did have a nice recovery, but it's not always guaranteed to happen like this. when we had the drops in 2000 and even in 2006, 9 area, it took 3 to 5 years for your money to come back to where it was before. The next fund we're gonna look at is SCHD, Schwab US Dividend Equity. Right now, dividend is 3.41. This particular fund has not only got a pretty good dividend on it, but it's also had some excellent growth. You can see that it's gone beyond where the market was before it dropped in March. If we look at the holdings on this, financial services, 26.52%, consumer defense, industrials, and some technology. So back to SCHD here. So you could not only earn a dividend on this, but you're also gonna build capital appreciation. You buy low, sell high. So you have both factors here helping you for your total return, yield and capital appreciation. The next dividend fund we're gonna look at is Fidelity Dividend ETF for Rising Rates, right now 3.04%. If we look at the holdings on this, very strong in technology and healthcare. So you could diversify from some of the other funds that have more financial services with this one that has more technology. Now we get into a dividend with a higher yield of 5.66%, Invesco S&P 500 High Dividend Low Volatility ETF. This one is higher in utilities, technology, and real estate. So again, this could give you a higher yield with some diversification from the first three that we looked at. The next fund we're gonna look at is SPYD, Spider S&P 500 High Dividend ETF at 5.56%. If we look at the holdings on this, high in financial services, real estate, utilities, energy. The next dividend fund is iShares Core High Dividend ETF at 4.4%, HDV is the symbol. Let's look at the sector weighting on this. Healthcare 20%, energy 18%. Energy stocks have been depressed. This could be an area where this particular fund really capitalizes on the growth of its dividend. The next one here is WisdomTree US Dividend minus the financials, symbol DTN at 4.17%. Let's look at the sector weightings here on WisdomTree. Utilities 13.15%, consumer defense, healthcare, industrials. If you look at this, this one's pretty much balanced all the way through. Pays a pretty good dividend, right around 4%, and it's balanced as far as its stock weighting. So not one particular area is going to affect this if something should start to move down. Let's take a little deeper look at this Invesco S&P 500 High Dividend Low Volatility ETF. If we look at the sector weighting again, we can see real estate, utilities, technology. Also on Yahoo here, you can go down to the top holdings, dig a little deeper and just look at some of the companies that it does invest in. This is Iron Mountain, Dow Inc., Huntington Bankshares, International Paper, Altria, PPL Corporation, Lumen Technologies, Hanes Brands, AT&T, Philip Morris. You can dig a little deeper and just see where the weighting is on some of these individual stocks. For the most part, they're all around 2 and 3%, so no one stock is overweighted. If we go back and look at Fidelity Dividend ETF for Rising Rates, let's take a look at the sector weighting, very high in technology and healthcare. If we dig a little deeper and look at the top holdings, we've got Apple, Microsoft, Johnson & Johnson, United Health, Pfizer, Procter & Gamble, AbbVie, Qualcomm, Amgen, Home Depot. So we can see some of the stocks. So this could not only give a person some good appreciation on your value, but also a good dividend play. So back to our viewer here, he said he had $500,000. He was getting $27,000 per month. He says over here, if you had $275,000, let's just take a look at that, do a simple calculation here. $275,000, and let's just say you could get a dividend of 4.5%. So multiply that times 045 equals about $12,000 per year. And if you add that to your Social Security, that's going to give you an extra amount of money to cover your expenses in retirement. If you have any questions about dividend ETFs, leave a comment. We thank you for watching. Stay tuned for future updates.